At some point or other, it happens to every game. Computers get better and better at it, and then one day, they surpass human level and beat the champion. In checkers, it happened in 1994, when the Chinook program beat Marion Tinsley. In chess, in 1997, when Deep Blue defeated Garry Kasparov. Most Go players, including myself, didn't feel any danger back then, because supposedly Go is a more complex game with too many variations to be solved by mere brute force. All AI that played Go was much weaker than human players. And yet, here we are. Less than 20 years after Deep Blue, in 2015, Google's DeepMind developed a new revolutionary Go AI that they called AlphaGo. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's start from the beginning. Before we talk about how the AI sneaked into the world of Go and why it even matters, I need to show you the basics of Go so that you understand what's happening here. Now, Go is one of those games that has very simple rules, but is surprisingly complex later as you start playing it. So we have these black and white pieces that are called stones, and then you start placing them on the board on any empty intersection. So black starts first and plays the first move. Anywhere, white responds. Black plays another move. White plays another move. And the game keeps going this way. The point of the game is to use the stones to surround territory. You need to divide this board into areas. And you can also capture your opponent's stones, but that's not the main objective. For example, if white has a stone here, it has four adjacent intersections. And if black takes all of them, like this, black is going to capture this stone. As simple as it gets. These are all the rules of Go. Now that you know the basics of Go, let me tell you how little we believed in the AI all those years back. You know, we had super strong chess engines a long time ago, but when we started playing Go, you only needed to practice it for a few months to beat the strongest computers available at the time. And I'm not only talking about even games here, because Go has a very nice handicap system. So for example, if I'm the weaker player and I want to play against you, being the stronger player, then we can make the game interesting for both of us. We can put several stones on the board before the game begins. For example, if I'm black, I will put two stones like this before we start playing. These stones will help me get territory. If this is not enough, maybe we'll put three stones, maybe four stones, maybe even five stones, or maybe more. The more stones I have before the game even begins, the harder it will be for you as white to build your territory here. Now imagine this. A strong amateur player at that time would give the computer this much handicap. Just look at that. The entire board is filled with black stones. It seems like it's really impossible for white to make any territory on that board. Everything belongs to black. And yet the human player would beat the computer quite effortlessly. It really seemed like the AI had a lot to learn back then. Any game in Go has a lot of unpredictability, so a human player would often not calculate everything precisely just because it's impossible, but play a move based on intuition and feeling. How could a machine replicate that? Or so we thought. And yet, over the years, new algorithms were developed and the machines were slowly becoming better and better. Until it all changed in 2015. The AlphaGo team contacted Fan Hui, a two-dan professional player from China originally, but he was living in France, and back then he was a three-time European Go champion. So it was a very natural choice. Naturally, Fan Hui was skeptical, because, you know, experience told him that no computer program could ever beat a human. But it became obvious after the first game that now things were different. They played the first game, second game, he lost the third game, the fourth game, all five games of that match. That was a shocking result, but somehow I remember that the world of Go wasn't really shaken. We still didn't believe that this was maybe the true and definitive match of machine versus human. So AlphaGo and DeepMind needed a bigger challenge, and they found it. They arranged a match with a true legend, Lee Sedol from South Korea. The match was to be played the following year. At that time, in 2015, Lee Sedol was like Michael Jordan in the world of Go. He won 18 international titles, and he was famous for his aggressive and intuitive style. They really couldn't have chosen a better opponent for AlphaGo. Before the match, Lee Sedol was shown the five games against the European champion. And just like Fan Hui before him, Lee Sedol was a little skeptical. He could see that the level of those games wasn't really on par with his own. So he thought he was going to win that match very easily. What he didn't know was that AlphaGo was going to get more training before the match. We all waited for March 2016. The anticipation at the time was tremendous, I can tell you that. Bets were being made and most of those were placed on the human champion and against the machine. I remember that I was living in China at the time and somehow I got myself a few days off just to watch, to be able to watch the broadcast. There was a live broadcast with commentary in different languages, and in Seoul, South Korea, they even put giant screens out on the street so that people could just see the live coverage right there. The first game started, and it was surprising right from the beginning, because AlphaGo, for some reason, decided to start a fight against Lee Sedol very early in the opening of the game. Because it was everyone's belief at the time that a machine starting a crazy fight against a strong human, that cannot be advantageous for the machine. And yet, somewhat effortlessly, AlphaGo wins the first game. Lee Sedol was somewhat taken aback, but of course now the real fight was to begin. Game 2 comes, and this is where something really interesting happened. The machine played a move that surprised everyone watching, including me. That was the move that we knew wasn't possible, just because this is very basic knowledge. As a human player, you know that that move just cannot be played. And yet, the machine played it. This showed everyone that AlphaGo was able to transcend the original datasets, transcend the human games that it was learning from, and then find something new, find something creative. AlphaGo won the second game as well. Now Lee Sedol had to do something extraordinary to try and turn the tables in this match. And he started a huge fight right from the early opening in game 3. And it didn't work either. The machine won the third game. The match was over. But perhaps the most spectacular moment of the whole match happened in game 4, surprisingly, when Lee Sedol already had no chance of winning the match. AlphaGo was ahead by about 10 points on the board, so Lee Sedol was losing that game as well. And yet, at the crucial moment, he managed to find an incredible move that no one watching the game could see, and that move just somehow made AlphaGo glitch, and it didn't know how to figure it out, didn't know how to solve it, and AlphaGo started losing. Later, now, armed with super powerful AI, we know that that move was not supposed to work. But in that match, against that version of AlphaGo, magically, it did. Lee Sedol won that game, and until today, this remains the only victory against that machine that humans ever had. The final score of the match was 4-1, and that's how it happened that humans finally lost to machines in the game of Go. But if AlphaGo could improve so much since the first match up until the second one, what if you give it more time for training? Well, they tried that, and they made stronger versions of AlphaGo after this match. But something interesting happened a year later. They released a very different version of AlphaGo called AlphaGo Zero. And it was named Zero because that version learned to play Go from scratch. It didn't start from any database of human games. So it was just given the basic rules of Go, and then it started playing against itself. The first games, the first thousands of games, were probably terrible, just playing moves at random. But, you know, AlphaGo kept playing millions and millions of games, and gradually the performance improved. And in the end, that version of AlphaGo outperformed all the versions that came before it. So excluding the human factor proved to be best for the machine. Now, almost 9 years after the match, Superhuman Go AI is available to everyone. And I think it's both a blessing and a curse. Now we have answers to many thousand-year-old questions in Go. Before, we had to question it and learn and think, but we would never know. Now, AI just tells us that this is the best move. But at the same time, the actual best solution to many situations in Go happened to be quite simple. And if before AI, we would study games of strong players from 50 years ago, 100 years, maybe even 200 years ago, and all of them would have incredibly different styles. But now, everyone is learning from the AI, and everyone is choosing the same moves. Besides, now with the rise of AI, Go players have the same problem that chess players have been having for years before that. Now everyone's afraid of cheaters, and before a tournament, you're supposed to pull out your phone and leave it on the table, because even some AI in your phone can play better than world-class professionals. But let's not make it sound too negative or discouraging. That AI victory 9 years ago meant a lot more than just the AI learning how to play a game of Go or tic-tac-toe or StarCraft. AlphaGo showed us how AI can be trained correctly to do anything. And now in 2024, we have ChatGPT that can understand human speech. We have AI generating images or videos, AI making music, and much, much more. At this point, the AI research is far from complete, and you never know how far it can take us as a species. As you can see, on this channel, we don't spend the whole time just studying how to play this game. We also talk about interesting topics around the game. And if you like this, then hit the like button, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. This is Go Magic.